everyone. This is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my rewind spread and it's for the week of November 12th through November 18th. And I'm really back planning this because today is actually already December 11th. So I'm about a month behind right now in my planning. And I know most of you, I think, don't mind the rewind spreads, you know, even if it's out of season, I think you guys still want to see it. But for those of you that don't prefer to watch older spreads, I'm super sorry, but you can go ahead and just skip these ones until I am hopefully more caught up sometime in the future. So today's kit is super gorgeous. I'm really excited about it. It's from The Giving Girl and this is her Dreamer kit. I'm not sure if it's still available on her website. I know she does hold on to kits for quite a while, so it may still be available. But anyways, we have 9 full boxes here and then this double box here says Dreamer. And as you can see, it's in gold foil, which makes it so much more beautiful. On this page, we have the date covers and the bottom washi, which has little specks of like gold foil dots and stars, which is so pretty. We've got a dainty weekend banner and then all the date dots at the bottom. I think I skipped a page, yeah. On here, this page, we have all of the date covers, little things, sidebar trackers, and it comes with 3 full box ones and then 2 of the habit trackers and also 2 Bill-Do stickers. And then this page, we've got some online order banners at the top. We have some little icons here that have some gold foil dots, if you can see that, some text stickers, glitter headers that also have the gold foil dots, and then these are like marbled headers, which are really pretty. On this page, we have checklists, we have flags with little icons, and then a bunch of plain colored washi strips or headers. I think they're headers because they're all the same size. And then these floral pattern headers on the side. On this page, we have all the half boxes, the third boxes, some scallop labels, quarter boxes, and then little things. There's lots of different varieties. And then over here we have the full box checklist. So we have 3 heart ones down here and then these just have little circle icons. And then the last page has more gold foiling. Oh my gosh, this is so gorgeous. It has some flags at the top. We have another full box or maybe 3 other full boxes here. We've got some little strips of, I think, different sized washi and then some deco at the bottom. So this is a really, really full kit. And honestly, if I remember correctly, I picked this up when she was having $12 Thursday. And so all 8 pages of gold foiling for this kit was only $12, which is probably like the best deal that there ever was. But anyways, I'm super excited to use this. I know I'll have tons of leftovers, but I will save that for my little leftovers collection and then do a giveaway for you guys in a couple weeks. So look out for that if you're interested. And for now, I'm going to start by putting down the bottom washi and then I'll build the spread from there. For this week, I did have to white out the bottom lines on my Erin Condren because the bottom washi was a little bit light in color and the lines would peek through behind them and I didn't like that, so I go ahead and white it all out. Once I'm done with my washi, I move onto my sidebar really quick and I put down the full box with the heart in the top corner. Now I'm just placing down all of the date covers, and again, I had to white out some of the dates on my planner so that they didn't peek through. And then I did have to check which date we were on so that I didn't put down the wrong date dots, but I was able to put them all down correctly. Yay. So once I'm all finished with that, I move back to my sidebar. Originally, I placed down this dark blue glitter header, but I do later switch it out for a lighter blue one instead. And it actually turned out that that was the only glitter header that I used in the spread. I put down one of the habit trackers to track my working out as I usually do, and this week I'm using my Paper Mate Enjoy gel pen, which I always use, and I think this is the 0.7. Underneath that, I put down a little things and wrote happy moments. I used one of the Monday through Sunday boxes for my happy moments, and then underneath I used a meals little things to mark my dinners, and I placed down the second Monday through Sunday box that came in the kit. I wanted the box to end where the bottom washi ended as well, so I ended up scooting things a little bit to make everything fit nicely. I do want to mention that I love the way this paper feels because it's super smooth. I think it's like a premium matte, but it was so sticky on my planner, and so every time I lifted up any sticker, it like ripped off the top layer of my planner, and eventually I finally pulled out my undo, but it would still peel up part of my planner. So it was just really hard for me to work with because I constantly switch things around when I'm planning. So anyways, on Monday I put down a full box initially, and that Veterans Day lettered sticker is from Paper and Milk. Underneath that, I put down a quarter box with a TV icon from the kit because we watched this Evolution show on Netflix, but I can't remember what it was called. And then I used a Today header with a two-heart checklist to mark that we got boba and did some groceries. The boba sticker is from Plans with Vanessa. I then realized that I wouldn't have enough space to fit everything that I wanted on Monday, and so I lifted up the full box at the top, and this is when I started realizing how difficult it was to lift up the boxes. I replaced the Veterans Day sticker on top of a half box and also pulled in a little piece of deco just to jazz it up. Underneath that, I put a flag sticker and then brush lettered no work because we did not have work that day because of Veterans Day. And then I decided to move up the stickers a little bit, and here is where I'm pulling out my undo because again, I was having so much trouble pulling up those stickers. That afternoon, I did record my voiceover and also edited my plan with me. So the record script sticker is from Love Shira. I put down a full box at the end of the day, and then I pulled in these gold foiled bow checklists from White Deer Stationery to mark a couple other places that I went to grab groceries. And then on Monday, I don't know why I was feeling so adventurous, but I decided to make tonkatsu curry, which turned out to be so good. So tonkatsu is like a Japanese fried pork chop, and it was my first time ever deep frying anything, and it turned out really, really well. So I was pretty happy with that. The curry sticker is from Soul sticker. And then moving to Tuesday, I started by putting down an important header at the top, and then I used a quarter box with a coffee sticker from the kit to mark that I needed coffee that morning after coming back from a three-day weekend. I then used a scallop label with a film clapper from Mandy Plans, or Mandy Dreams, I'm sorry, to mark that I uploaded my plan with me that morning. And then I had a few meetings at work that day, so I first put down a don't forget header with a full box, and that IEP flag is from Lily Grove Designs. If you're new to my channel, IEPs are meetings that we hold for students who are in special education, and I do work with a lot of students in special education, so I attend those meetings quite regularly. At the bottom of the full box, I wanted to mark a staff meeting, and because there was like a little deco, like floral pattern on the right-hand side, I didn't want to cover that up with anything, but I did find this gold foil bow sticker from Student Planning, and I decided to pull that in just to add a little more gold foil. Underneath that, I put down a half box with another IEP flag from Lily Grove Designs to mark another IEP I had that day. When I got home, I did my workout, so I put down a workout shoe sticker from Bloom Paper Studio, and then at the very bottom, I put down a little things with a laptop sticker from Sticker Blush to mark that I did a YouTube binge that night because I think I was super tired from the meetings that I had. They were all pretty intense, so I just wanted to wind down that night. On Wednesday, Wednesday was a pretty chill day, so I put down the full box that had that pretty gold foiling, and I didn't want to cover that up at all. Then I went back to Monday and replaced the half box with one that was a lighter blue color because on Wednesday, I already started the day with dark blue, and so I like to kind of scatter the colors around my planner so that they're not, not the same colors are clumped together. Anyways, moving back to Wednesday, I used a third box with a little tack sticker from the kit to mark that I had to drop off something in the morning for a coworker. I used a half box with another IEP flag to mark a meeting, and then that day I got home really late. After the meeting, I had just a lot of things to wrap up, so I put down a flag and then a defeated, tired girl from Art Box stickers. I then put down a quarter box, and I actually moved to the bottom first, so I put down a bed sticker from Toffee Bananas. I think that came in a sampler, and I used that to mark that I went to sleep early that night because I was so, so tired. And then on top of the third box, I really didn't have anything else to mark. It was a super uneventful day, so I just put down some utensil stickers. Those are from Dots Papeterie to mark the dinner that we had that night. Then on Thursday, I started by using a Today header at the top. I put down that third box with a pencil sticker from Nikki Plus 3 to mark a staff meeting that we had that morning. And then that was pretty much it for work. So then I used a flag sticker with a shoe from Simply Laura Paper Shop to mark that I did a high intensity interval training workout that day. I think that's what it stands for. I then moved to Friday first because I wanted to use that Dreamer double box on Thursday and Friday because those were some pretty uneventful days for me, and I was going to be able to have space for the double box. So anyways, for Friday, I put down a half box at the top with a gold foil heart sticker that's from Clever Gal Crafts. Then I used a third box and another coffee icon from the kit to mark that I got my usual Friday coffee. And then like I mentioned, I put down the Dreamer double box right in the middle of Thursday and Friday. I ended up lifting it halfway because the lines between Thursday and Friday were totally showing through from under the box, and I really didn't like how that looked, and so I sacrificed lifting up the sticker, which was really difficult, to white out the lines. Then continuing with Thursday, I put down a half box and a dim sum sticker from Mochi Kichi because my friend and I went and got Din Tai Fung, which is like one of my favorite restaurants, if you guys don't know by now. And they have like the best soup dumplings ever, and I was super excited I got to go. And then because Din Tai Fung is inside a mall, we ended up going shopping for a little bit afterwards. I didn't really find anything I wanted, / I was too full and too tired to try things on. So anyways, that shopping bag sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. At the bottom, I layered two washi strips on top of each other, and then I put down the little things on top of that because I just wanted to take up a little extra room. The little things is very thin. And I also used a gold foil heart from Clever Gal Crafts to mark that I talked to my friend on the phone because she was having a really tough night. Then moving to Friday, I put down that bow, I don't know what it's called, like a divider sticker at the top, just because I thought it was really cute. And then those balloon stickers were from my leftover collection, so I don't know what shop they were from, unfortunately. I brush lettered Thanksgiving break because Friday was our last day of work before we had an entire week off for Thanksgiving. I'm very lucky to work in a district where we get the entire week off because by the time it rolls around, it is so necessary. And to celebrate, my boyfriend and I went out to get some sushi for dinner. The date night emoji sticker is from the Coffee Monsters Co. Unfortunately, when I got home that night, I started feeling super sick. I feel like my body was just fighting it off all week. I was starting to feel the symptoms, but I was just fighting it off until I finally got a break. So anyways, that sad girl sticker is from Sun Fun Stickers. When I woke up on Saturday, I was still feeling really sick. But first I put down the weekend banner. So behind the weekend banner, I layered a couple strips of the marbled gold foil washi. And then when I lifted up the weekend banner, it did rip where the D was. And so I ended up replacing that other little part of the D on weekend. So hopefully that made sense. I put down a full box at the bottom of Saturday because I knew that's where I wanted it. And then moving back to the top, I used a scallop label with a sad emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark that I was still feeling really sick on Saturday. So I pretty much spent the whole morning just resting and laying in bed and trying to feel better. I then placed down this larger strip of like washi or header, and I was trying to be really careful not to place it on top of my planner because, like I said, this paper just stuck to my planner like so crazy. But as you can see, it still ripped up part of my planner, and so I did have to pull out my glue stick to glue it down, I think a couple different times actually. And anyways, I used a boba sticker on top of that, and that is from Love Shira because we did go and get some boba. And then after looking at what I wanted to put down on Saturday, I decided I needed to take up a little bit more room, so I added a header and a little things at the very top. I then replaced the other two stickers, and actually now I'm thinking about it, I decided to add something to the top of Saturday because I realized that the middle section of my planner didn't have any navy blue, and so I wanted to pull in that navy blue color closer towards the middle. Then I used a half box, and on top of that, I put down a cleaning icon. And on the half box, I wanted to mark that my boyfriend's parents came down for the night to see us, and then they spent the night as well. So it was really good to see them. We spent some time catching up, and then we watched some TV and also ordered pizza, which was awesome. That gold foil bow sticker is from White Deer Stationery. And then moving to Sunday, I started by putting down a full box at the top, and I did have to trim it down a little bit because I wanted to make sure I could fit everything else on that day. I first used a Little Things to mark that I picked up some bread at 85 Bakery, and then I put down a half box with a toast sticker from Happy Dia Stickers. That's one of my favorites. I think it's so cute. And then I brush lettered brunch and feminism because a couple of my friends and I decided to start this like feminism group where we found some interesting thought-provoking questions about feminism, and we wanted to be able to discuss them and just talk about how like our life experiences have contributed to the way that we feel or express feminism in our own lives. So when I got home, I still wasn't feeling very well, so I did take a very long nap. I put that on a quarter box with a napping sticker from the Coffee Monsters Co. When I woke up, I did fill my plan with me, so I used a Love Shira sticker to mark that. And then that night, I did a yoga workout because I did want to work out, but I didn't feel like doing something very intensive because I wasn't feeling 100%. And then at the end of the night, I just watched some TV, so I put that on a Little Things at the very bottom of Sunday. So that's it for my week this week. And then, yeah, now I'm just filling in my sidebar, and once I'm done with that, I'm just showing you these stickers that I have left. So yeah, that is my final spread, and I think it turned out so beautiful. I hope you think so as well. I've been holding on to this kit and I'm so excited I got to use it. The paper situation was really tricky for me just because I do tend to lift up so much in my planning. I know it's awful how often I change things around, but I do tend to be really indecisive, especially when I love a kit so much and want to make it look good in my planner. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching and for sticking with me through these rewind spreads. I really appreciate your support, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.